In our previous video, we looked at the main Suite Builder elements. Now it's time to dig a little deeper into each one of those, starting with custom fields. Let's start by looking at the standard field types. There are over 20 different field types to choose from. To see a complete explanation of these, you should check out the Suite Answers page on custom fields. You can access the link below. While most of these field types are self-explanatory, some of them may appear to overlap. Let's compare and contrast some of these apparently similar field types. First, we have date, date time, and time of day. The main thing to keep in mind with these three field types is that the date time option essentially merges the other two together. If you need just the date, then use the date option. If you just want the time of day, use the time of day option. If you need both, then instead of using those two fields together, you would just need a single date time field. Note that when a user is putting information in either a date or date time field, those dates and times would reflect the user's time zone. A second confusing group of field types includes freeform text, text area, rich text, and long text. The main difference among these field types is the amount of information that each can hold. Freeform text, which is the most common of these field types, allows 300 characters. Text area gives you 4,000 characters, while rich text provides up to 100,000 characters. And finally, long text provides up to 1 million characters. Note that the character limit for each of the text fields shows the maximum characters that could be available to users. When you create a text field, you will always have the option of further restricting the number of characters you want users to have. Note also that when you use rich text, you can also format what the text looks like as far as font size, style, color, etc. None of the other text fields have this functionality. A third confusing group includes the field types decimal number, integer number, and percent. While these three field types all involve numbers, their uses are self-explanatory. You should decide which one to use based on how you want any information in the fields to be formatted. Some things to note are that the decimal number field holds up to 21 digits, and that the percent field will automatically apply the percent symbol to numbers. Next, let's take a look at the standard field categories. You may notice that when you go to customization, lists, records, and fields, there are 7 field categories to choose from. However, if you compared the pages where you create new fields in each of these categories, you would see that they are overall quite similar. So why do we need the different categories? Essentially, the field categories connect the fields that you're creating with the records and transactions you want those fields to appear on. For example, if you needed to add a field to an entity record like an employee or vendor record, you would use the entity fields category. If you needed to add a field to a particular line on a transaction, you would use the transaction line fields category. If you needed to add a field to a record that isn't on one of the standard options, you would use the other record fields category. Once you know what kind of field you need, the field type, and where you need the field to be, the field category, you are ready to create a custom field. For the sake of an example, let's create a custom field on an employee record. Navigate to Customization, Lists, Records and Fields, Entity Fields, and New. At the top of the Custom Entity Field page, you must label your new field. This name will be visible to users. After labeling your custom field, you can provide an optional ID, designate the owner of the field if you need it to be someone other than yourself, and write a brief description of the field. Then, select the type of field you need. If it is a list record field, you will also need to choose the list you want to be associated with the field. Notice that the store value checkbox is automatically checked, and unless you have a special reason for wanting values not to be stored in your new field, you should leave it checked. Following the initial fields are 5 subtabs: applies to, display, validation and defaulting, sourcing and filtering, and access. Notice that the content of some of these subtabs may vary depending on the field type you have previously selected. The applies to subtab is perhaps the most important of the 5, since this is where you would choose exactly which entities would include your custom field. The other subtabs enable you to do things like decide exactly where the field appears on a record, limit who can edit the field, and set the field to mandatory. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.